This is home. And our roots run as deep as the love we have for this place. Owned by the same Cincinnati company for more than 70 years. And what matters to you matters to us.
I'm Evan Millward. Here's a look at some of the top stories at this hour. The suspect in a shooting that hurt four, including two young kids, answers to a judge. 19-year-old Darius Harris Jr. is charged with four counts of felonious assault. He was also shot. He appeared in court today in a wheelchair. He's now being held on $1 million bond, a quarter million per charge. He is charged for Saturday's shooting near McHenry and Kavanaugh in Westwood. The victims range in age from 6 to 18 years old. Most are at home recovering. But 8-year-old Marcellus Whitehead is in a medically induced coma. His mom made this plea to the judge today.
As you get for him, whatever you put, the max, because my baby fighting. He is still on a ventilator. He is not opening his eyes. He got fluid around his lungs. His brain is swollen. The swelling is not going down.
We'll continue following this story for you. Now to Northern Kentucky, where authorities are officially calling a weeks-old investigation a double homicide. Kentucky State Police say they found Dylan Carpenter and Madison Klupps shot to death in DeMossville, that's in Pendleton County, on May 28th. They were found in a home on Straub Lane there. Anyone with information about this should call KSP. Ohio's next Vax-a-Million winners are named tonight. One vaccinated adult will win $1 million, and a 12 to 17 year old will get a full ride scholarship to any Ohio public college. You can watch that announcement on WCPO 9 at 7:29 tonight. And a reminder, you have until Sunday at midnight to enter for the final drawing. Really nice day out there, Sherry.
Yes, we have dew points in the 40s, which means dry air, lots of sunshine, some fair weather clouds, and temperatures that should top out around 80 degrees. And then tonight, we're going down to 55, clear skies. Then tomorrow, a touch more humidity, but still very pleasant as temperatures will reach the lower to mid 80s across the tri-state. Rain chances, though, are back on Friday. Could even see some storms. And for Father's Day, we're likely going to see some pop-up showers and storms then as well, with temperatures around 86.